can be really a pain sometimes.
With a smile on your face, you go into construction.
This is for me right now.
Everything is possible and you are the best example of it.
I said 5 mil is the best I can do.
I'm going to be talking today with Zhao, who I can tell you now is the best example for all the young people looking for their career in construction or whatever path they're choosing for their future. As with his positivity and energy, nothing can stop you. My name is Greg and my mission here is to inspire more and more people to join the construction industry, and definitely Zhao will help me with it. If you could tell us a few words about yourself.
My name is Zhao and I'm 20 years old and I will be a university student in next month actually, and in my degree in construction engineering management at Loughborough University. Perfect. And currently I am a trainee engineer with a company called Ashcourt Group.
How do you find working on site anyway, like an engineer now?
So I really do enjoy it. And to be fair, this is not the first time I joined in engineering actually. And when I was 15, no, actually, when I was 13, when BAM Construction was building my old school, I was speaking to the construction manager on site. He invited me onto site. And yeah, I brought my hat with me here. And with my name on as well.
Oh, that's great, yeah. I want people to see this.
Yeah, and he's the most important person in my career up to now. So he directed me. So when I was 15, in year 10, he gave me a work experience in a local site, which is a manual job. And I was working with an engineer on there. He taught me like basics of set up a total station. And yeah, I got into my A-levels. I finished my A-levels last year, and yeah, I applied for university because I decided to take a year out to get some experience before I start university, so I know exactly what am I doing.
Yes, that's great. Yeah, so you see guys, that's the best solution, to start as soon as possible on site. You started really early, like, so I don't know, you got that opportunity in BAM, so you were lucky a little bit, but
yeah,
what I'm always saying, like, people just try to get on site as soon as possible, and you started really early. That's great, man. I just see the bright future for you, to be honest, myself. What I wanted to ask you as well, like, when you work on site, what were your main duties, especially when, because you're working as a site engineer now, or still like an apprentice and junior engineer?
I'm a trainee engineer, so which is like a junior engineer as well.
Okay.
So my duties is that I will be assisting the proper engineers. We've got a few engineers in the company, so
okay.
I'm assisting them on the setting out. For example, my boss, the engineer, he'll say to me, Joe, you can set up the total station, do the resections, and we'll come back to you. So yeah, that's my task, like assisting them on setting out. So mainly I'm working on a corridor scheme, which is roadworks, setting out curb lines, edgings, drainage as well. Yeah, so I did that, and now last week we completed the project, and so now we're just getting up to date with the QA, quality assurance, and yeah, that's what my task really is.
Yeah, but that's great, man.
Yeah.
I can say, especially if you're now dealing with the QA as well and all the stuff. That's all actually,
yeah,
all engineering,
it can be a
really.
Headache sometimes.
Yeah, but that's, you know, at least you know now, you know, you're still young and then you're dealing with all this now. This is just great, you know? Great,
yeah,
for you,
it's
I mean.
Fun.
And
it is fun.
Fun, yeah, definitely. Yeah. I was thinking maybe if you could tell us what you think about the pros and cons of working in construction. I know you're just starting, but you've seen working on site, so that's definitely what people want to know about, you know?
Yeah, because I say majority, in my opinion, are pros. Because obviously you're a young starter on site and everyone just really welcoming you, especially from the senior management to my managers, from the director level all the way to the lads on site as well.
Okay.
Everyone gives you enough support and give you a bit. We've got a question to ask them, they'll definitely answer you. They won't be like just throw you away and be really arrogant and stuff like that.
won't
be like that. And yeah, we've been really supportive and really happy about that overall. And also getting some invaluable hands-on experience. That's all the pros as well. And also, I said the little bit of con is that because it's engineering, isn't it? It's construction. Weather is a little bit of a con.
Yeah, yeah.
It can be pretty cold. already warm like recently.
That's another thing what Zhao said about people. You people you're working with, really. So I think, yeah, you got the supportive people. That's a very important thing. And on some jobs, you're going to find some maybe arrogant even people. So don't be discouraged by this, really. You know, this is construction. So on my last interview with Eddie, she mentioned like maybe 1% of people. They're always going to be someone. So don't be discouraged by it. And you're always going to find supportive people and people who want to help you. So just stick to them. And yeah, I think that's it. And what advice you would give to people, especially maybe people like you were 15 years old when you were starting, really. So I know people looking for their path there and they're not really sure what they're going to be doing. But maybe you could tell them something.
What my suggestion for young people is that definitely go for it. So if you try something that you don't, you try something you don't like it, you know that you don't like it. So yeah. So I say in construction, there is really a role for everyone, because if you don't like going on site often, then you got office based work. Obviously, you could maybe be an administrator dealing with everything else, the paperwork side on site. And yeah, there's really work for everyone. Apart from engineers, you get QSs, you get estimators, site managers, everything. And yeah, you can also, you won't just be stuck in one role. You can definitely move your way up. And not just management roles as well, for roles like the trades on site. I think, Greg, you mentioned on your previous video that you started off in steel fixing, is that right?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So, well, I got a level 2 qualification myself. I did a bit of joinery and brickwork as well. I say,
that's
even
great.
These lads have opportunity to be managers, even directors, because a bit of anecdote, my manager, he's a contract manager. He literally started off as a ground worker and he's all the way up as a contract manager now.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what I'm trying to, you know, tell people that just lots of people trying to be like managers, but straight away, you know, they don't like...
Yeah, because
it's
on site,
crazy.
We've been told on site that if you never get hands-on experience... And a bit of anecdote, so they won't listen to you.
Exactly, that's the thing. You have to go through this, you have to put your hands in it, and then, yeah.
Yes, and exactly.
That's what you said, there's the industry is so big that there's plenty of opportunities, like you said, yeah, estimators, QSs, or even start working like a ground worker or on site, like joiner, and then you can step up. And I personally know many people, like many engineers now, who are really good engineers, and they started like this, so... That's another way, and I think that's a really good way. I think, guys, you should go for it. Or if you got a chance, just start like Zhao here. That's perfect. Like if you're 15 years old, you start on site, and then you know that's the thing you want to do. That's just great, man.
Yeah, absolutely loving it. And just a little bit more to add on. The engineer I worked with back then, 5 years. I finally got some news off. From him, but not from him, from someone else.
Okay.
He just came out of university with a master's degree, and now he's actually a design engineer. He started off as a site engineer.
Okay, yeah, so that's another one. I think that's, I cannot imagine a really good designer or the structural engineer who never actually was on site, and, you know, he tried himself, like, to see how it works. Especially, you know, where we were sometimes laughing, like, you know, the engineers, they drawing the lines, but then you see that rebar, everything has to come inside. So this is great. Especially I, as a steel fixer, you know, I had that steel fixing experience.
Yeah.
Everything on the drawing looks perfect, but then on site, sometimes it's even impossible to do. So that's another one.
Yeah.
Why you would like experience on site, really. So
yeah, you need to make sure everything's buildable, really.
Yeah. That's all. But to be honest, you only know when you're going to be working on site, because that's the eye opener. You need to be there to see how it works, and then only you can just start going back to your design, to everything.
Yeah.
Okay, Zhao, so I think that would be all. Thank you very much for being here with us, and hopefully see you soon, maybe after your study, maybe first semester of your study, or first year of your study. We definitely want to see you here, and you're going to tell us how difficult studying civil engineering is.
Yeah, thank you very much for this opportunity, Greg. Nice to talk to you too.
I'm really happy to have you here. So that'll be slowly end of this video, and there was definitely a couple of lessons you should have from Zhao here, as he was talking about his contract manager starting from the ground worker. So as I always say, guys, have your dreams big, but start from the ground. So if you think about project management, you cannot really start as a project manager or a PM assistant even. It's impossible without experience. So you have to start low and then jump up the ladder and you're gonna get up there. And that's how it always works. A very good thing is to find some mentor, some friend, someone who can guide you a little bit, who can teach you, who will answer your questions. And guys, if you don't have anyone like this, remember, I'm here for you. Write to me, write some questions. I got the answers for you, and my video is actually here just to guide you through your career or just to inspire you to actually join the construction industry. So guys, thank you again for watching. Please don't forget to leave the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, as there will be more guests coming here and gonna be more civil engineering content. So thank you again and see you next time.